Special member request, we have Bones. I can see my house from here. I'll play all the parts right at the beginning here. Afterwards, I'll go back through, give the full explanation for it. If you like this video, hit that subscribe button. I'm coming out with videos quite frequent, so you don't want to miss it. And now, let's give it a try. Okay, so for the tuning on this, the lowest note that gets hit is a low B flat or A sharp. But you know, that's kind of a funky tuning just to, you know, if we were just going to make that the open low. So instead we'll try to use a lot more common tuning that, you know, what we can cover that low note with. And for that, we'll do what's typically like a drop A, which a lot of the seven stringers use, you know, like bands like Korn, stuff like that, where essentially they have, you know, their regular six strings, but on top of that, it would be their seventh, which typically is a B string. But if you do a drop tune with that, it just becomes a drop A. And that drop A will be able to, you know, cover that drop or the low A sharp or B flat note that we need and still be in a tuning that, you know, is fairly common and not just a one-off for this particular song. Okay, so we're in a drop A tuning. All right, so that'll be the low A here. E, A, D, G, B. So essentially it's, you know, a low A string, standard tuning from there on, and we're just cutting off the super high E string. All right, and this initial intro section here, kind of two clean guitars just over the top of each other. The initial one's just kind of doing this kind of elongated arpeggio vibe. And we'll start it here on the, what is now the B string. All right, and we'll be at the 10, all right, on the B. And we hit that, and then we'll jump up to this second string, the G, and we go 7-6. Hold that a moment, do it again, and then just repeat those last two notes again. And the second guitar, it's doing its own little scale over the top of that. It'll start here at the 7 on the first string, the B string. Hits that, comes up, does the 10, back down to 8 now. Does the 8 on the first string, and then comes up, hits the 9 on the second string, the G. All right, and then on the first string, goes 7-8 to the 7 on the second string, and then 6-7 on the second string, and just repeats that line. And now the heavier stuff, and this is, of course, where we're going to be using that low B flat A sharp note. Right? And this initial verse section, it's this very, you know, particular syncopated strumming that happens. It's kind of hard to explain. You just kind of need to listen to that part and, you know, just go over it. best I can describe it, you know, initially we have some palm muting going on. And like I said, just kind of working this first fret here for our, you know, B flat, A sharp note. And, you know, the pattern, we go one, two, little hesitation, one, two, hesitate, spread out a couple single strums, a couple strums closer together. Then we do, you know, some bunched up, like one, two, three, four, and then a quick little triplet. Like I said, it's a little difficult to explain. Just kind of listen to the recording and try to, you know, eyeball what, you know, the distance between the notes here that I'm trying to show you. So that's kind of like the first part of it. And then the second part of it, similar kind of stabs on it, you know, it's like a two strums, hesitate, one, do three, hesitate, couple more, hesitate, three, hesitate, and then couple more. And then at the very end, we do like an unmuted, just a little power chord, the quick one on the sixth and fifth string here, hit it. And then we go back to the muted one, two, three, hit it, one, two, three, hit it again. Now this pre-chorus section, I would call it, we're having some fun with, you know, kind of alternate strings here. And initially we're going to drop down to the fifth string and second fret. We're going to go one, two, three, drop down to the third string here, which is now the, you know, like the D string. And we hit the third fret and it's one, two, three there. All right. And we do that twice throughout this initial run through. Then we shift a bit. We keep the twos on the fifth string, one, two, three, and then we hit three first frets on that third string, all right? And then from there, shift over, and we go sixth fret on the fifth string, one, two, three, drop down, and we hit three fourth frets on the third string, one, two, three there, all right? Move over, and we're gonna do two of these where we go three fifth strings at the fourth fret. All right, drop down, hit the third fret on the third string three times. All right, do that twice. Okay, and then essentially at that point, we kind of like start it over, but we don't do that initial section twice. We just do it once. Then we move into that, you know, going from that second fret to third fret. All right, we just do that once, and then we move into our second fret to first fret, and we do that little bit twice now. So essentially, after we do that once, we can kind of start from that second section and just run it through from there. All right, so we go our two to ones, then we go to our sixes to fours, then the fours to threes for two, and that should get us into the chorus section. For the chorus section, we just basically switch to straight up like power chords. And with these power chords, we're just strumming away eighth note style, just keeping them going. All right, and just three chords, the initial one, two measures worth, we just do the second fret on the fifth string and the fourth fret on the fourth string here, all right, for that power chord, which is now, you know, like a F sharp in this tuning. And just wailing away on that, couple measures, just back and forth, eighth note strumming. All right, move it up to the sixth fret, all right, power chord there, with the eight on the fourth string, just one measure with that, and then just bump it down a couple frets so we have the four and the six for a measure there. All right, and we just repeat that whole thing two times. And now once we get into the outro, kind of split it up in two parts here, we have another like really syncopated specific pattern here. And with this one, we're bouncing between octaves with that A sharp, B flat there. So we're going between the first fret on the sixth string and the first fret on the fourth string here. And basically just really choppy staccato short notes here. You know, from the first on the sixth string to first on the fourth string, go back between those twice, hang on that sixth string for a couple there on the first fret. And now we kind of go back and forth between the first on the fourth, first on the sixth, a little quicker now. Do that twice and go finish at the first fret low. Two first frets on the fourth string, a little quicker now. Back to that first fret on the sixth string. And then we hit the first fret on the fourth string, spread them out a little bit more, and then we finish it by doing this palm muted, just quick 1, 2, 3, 4, come off to a couple open first fret power chords, bop, bop, hit them twice, and then we repeat that whole section two times. The second part of the outro, or basically the ending now, this is kind of where it starts fading out. Initially, we start at that second fret power chord on the fifth and fourth string. All right, and with this, another real distinct pattern now. Once, hit it once, let it ring a little bit, do a couple more closer together, a couple more a little further spread out, hesitate a moment there, and then we do just 1, 2, 3, couple strums closer together, one more strum, and then from there we bring it up and we hit 6th fret on that 5th string, couple of those, drop it down to the 4th fret, strum that out about 4 or 5 times quickly, and then at this point we kind of repeat that same pattern that we had, but we're just down a fret lower now at the 1st fret on the 5th string and 3rd fret on the 4th string, and at this part, you know, as we're going through that pattern with that chord, it starts fading out all the way.